Hello friends, I am Sanjay Gupta. I welcome you on Sanjay Gupta Tech School. In this video, I am going to demonstrate you how you can create global actions in Salesforce Lightning experience. Before starting, if you want to follow Salesforce training videos, you can search my name Sanjay Gupta on YouTube. And here you can find various playlists related to Salesforce and other programming languages. So you can follow it. Now to create global action, first you need to search global actions here. So here two options are available, global action and the publisher layout. So you can first select global action. So here you can see various pre-implemented or pre-built global actions are available. Here messages are available, create, edit, view global actions, which can be used on detail pages, home pages, and the chatter tab, right? Now here you can see this plus sign is showing some global actions that are listed here. So if you create any global action, so that will be available here. And you can also use them on detail page, home page, or chatter tab. So now I'm going to create new action. So there are various action types are available. So I'm going to use this one, create a record. Target object is employee. So I'm going to create a record through global action button for this employee object. Then label is, let's say, create employee. It's API. I am unchecking this and the success message. New employee record is created. Why I removed this checkbox? Because here you can read this. This message displays when an action is performed successfully, but does not create a feed item. And if we check this checkbox, so it will create a feed item. So I don't want to do that. I just want to create the record and success message. So I'm clicking on save. Now here you can see this global action page layout is available. So here it is asking for the fields that you want to show while clicking on that button. So it is automatically populating the required field. Now here I can put some more fields, let's say I'm putting these values, sorry, these fields. So these five fields will be available on the layout while I will be clicking on create employee global action. Now I'm clicking on save. So this layout will be created. You can click on edit so that you can edit the layout. Now I'm going to set up, moving to publisher layout. And here you can see only one layout is available, global layout. If you want to create new one, you can click on new and create your own global publisher layout. And you can assign that by clicking on that and click edit assignment, and you can choose that new global layout. But right now I just want to use this existing one. So I'm clicking on edit. And here I'm going to choose mobile and lightning actions and create employee. So I'm putting it here in the beginning and clicking on save. So this way I updated this global layout. And now I'm going to refresh this. So page is refreshing. Now I need to check this plus sign whether that global action is available here or not. Yeah, so here you can see this global action is available. If I click on it, so you can see the page layout. I can fill the details. Let's say ID is 10101, salary this much, career objective, let's say test, family background test, and designation test. And I'm clicking on save. So this is the success message. New employee record is created that we put while creating that global action. Now, if I refresh this page, click on employee tab. So here you can see this is the recently created one. And here you will see all the details. So I provided this ID. Designation test, this is the salary, and objective, background, both were test also. So this way this record is created through this global action. So I hope you understood how you can create global actions. And while creating global actions, so you can do these things as well. So I'm opening this one, clicking on new. So here you can see I created record, but you can do send email, log call, custom VF page, custom canvas and lightning component. So for these, you can also create global actions. So use these global actions as per your requirement. So I hope you understood how we can use existing as well as new global actions. So existing are already available here. And if you create new global action, you just need to modify the publisher layout. And that global action that you created will be available. So I hope you understood whatever I demonstrated in this video. If you want to watch more Salesforce training videos, you can search my name, Sanjay Gupta, on YouTube. And you can watch various videos related to Salesforce and other programming languages by going to the playlist. So thank you for watching this video.